Red. Thank you. This is cool, man. Man, what a convention this year. Yeah. It's getting bigger and bigger every year. I'm afraid what next year is going to bring. I mean, if I'm around next year. Super cool. We want to do some questions, I assume, right? You know, I can hardly answer any questions. Scott Gimple's probably sitting out in the audience right now with his little notebook just going, in the doghouse again. How are we going to work this? We've got just a microphone passing around? God, there is a lot of you here. Savior from Rock. Look, somebody gave me a donkey. It's my little Paxton, yeah. So when I'm not home, I just got my little pal that follows me around everywhere. I might bring Paxton to the sanctuary. Need to straighten out some people. A little donkey kick to the head and be all right. All right, how are we doing? I can't see Diddley Squad. Is that you? Oh, right here. Hey, my man, what's up? Oh, it's Peyton. Peyton, I don't have my glasses on. It's good to see you.
I just want to know who was your favorite to film on Supernatural?
Who's my favorite? I mean the boys. I mean, you understand. All my stuff was really with the boys anyway, Jensen Ackles and Jared Padalecki. But Peyton, I gotta tell you something. I haven't been on that show since you've probably been born. I think the last time I was on it was like 12 years ago or something. I did just see Jared and Jensen both. I did a Supernatural convention recently, and then Jensen and his wife and his little oldest daughter, JJ, came into the farm and hung out and took selfies with Paxton, as is the thing. I'm gonna get that donkey his own booth next year. So yeah, I love film with him. Those two dudes are two of the nicest guys in this business. I mean, I'm gonna not take any away from the cast of The Walking Dead, who are all awesome, but Jensen and Jared, I've known for 15 years, and they haven't changed a bit. I mean, not a bit. They're those still the same two dudes they were 15 years ago. And that's hard to do after you're doing a show for 13 years, to stay humble and cool and awesome, and they've managed to do it. Unlike me, who's just turned into a freaking nightmare. Thanks, babe. Yeah, part two.
I'm mom.
I know.
I want to say thank you for making her Make-A-Wish so amazing yesterday. You are
amazing. Well, Peyton's going to come and hang out with me later, right? Yeah, cool. All right, sweet. Of course, I'm a, kids. Yeah, I'm a fan. Peyton's one in a million. Oh, thank you. Yeah, I'm having another kid, speaking of. And my wife was like, you're doing a panel today? I'm like, yeah. She goes, can you just keep your mouth shut? Probably not. I'm sure I'll spill something I'm not supposed to. I got Gimple and Hillary back there. Asshole. Dummy. How do you sign asshole? Kind of like that it ends there. I feel like Negan can throw that out. All right, where are we now? Oh, I see where we are. What's up, my man?
Hey, I don't know if you remember, but back in San Francisco.
I remember.
Yeah.
Okay. This little dude was dressed up like Negan, and I brought him up on stage in San Francisco, and he had a whole deal. That you got a thing? You got a thing you want to do?
I was just wanting to say I have gotten better, and this time I have brought a goddamn tiger.
Get up the stairs here. They know what's up. What's your name again, dude? It's Jackson or something, right?
Jake.
Jake. I knew it was a J. That's not bad.
Jillian.
Shiva. All right, let's see this. Ladies and gentlemen, Shiva.
You've got your shit pants on. I hope you're wearing them, because you're going to be shitting your pants.
Shiva talks? I got to get a goddamn tiger.
Rawr, bitch.
You guys very much. And by the way, yeah, you nailed it. I'm getting better and better. Pretty soon, you can just take over my job, brother. Thank you, Shiva. Huh. Who needs a donkey when I got a tiger? Thank you, guys. It was an honor to have you up here, my man. Goddamn tiger. Today's youth, I'm so honored to be a role model. Oh, Negan, tell me a bedtime story. Oh, okay, where we at over here? Okay.
What would you do if you were Negan and you met up with Carolyn?
Oh my God. If I were Negan and I met up with Carol, I'd say, lady, could you bake me some cookies? And probably put a bullet in my skull. She'd be like, Negan, look at the flowers.
Also, we designed something specially for your little baby girl.
You did?
Can we bring it up to you?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Yeah, just chuck it up here. Let me see. Oh, look at that. I'm blind, but I can't make out a beach ball. Oh, that's awesome. So my little girl gets a shirt here. I don't have my glasses on, but I imagine it says something about having beach ball-sized lady nuts. Just what every newborn needs.
We designed the first.
Let me see what it says. This girl has beach ball-sized lady nuts because Negan is my daddy. Sorry, Peyton, don't listen to me. Come hang out with me, and I promise you, my booth, I'm really nice. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
I almost just said, by the way, the baby's name. I almost just blew it. Little needs, little baby needs. I see y'all. Oh, changing the batteries. I can sit and wait, but I'm gonna go over here. Go, dude.
Hello, my name is Negan. So,
oh man.
know that even though Nate Negan, we still love him, but he's in charge of this community and he's still kept them in line. Do you think he does that through fear, and has he told them about Rick's group and whether they're the enemy?
My folks, my people.
The people you lead, do you think Negan's told them?
Oh, fuck yeah. Oh, yeah, we're in a war. I had to break the news to them.
Do you think they see Rick as the
Remember the last episode of last year is me standing in front of a group of people like y'all saying we are going to war. They're in on it.
Do they think?
Rick killed, I don't know, 70 of my people last year. I killed two. Well, and then like, Denise took a bullet to the eye. There might have been a couple others, but two. Negan two, Rick 70. Yeah, I love Abraham too. Yeah, he was great. I cried myself to sleep every night about Abraham. That's what he gets for saying, suck my nuts. I think he got off easy. But I understand your love for Abraham. I personally was more of a Glenn guy, but I miss them both on the show. They're both great guys, and I see them, you know, frequently at conventions like this. And we still get a kick out of the fact that I get all sorts of shit for doing something that I didn't write. You know, I'm a paid actor. I show up, they give me some stuff, and I do it. And hopefully y'all think it's nifty or hate it or whatever it is. But when you see me walking down the street, my name is Jeffrey Dean Morgan. You can flip me off. You can tell me I'm an asshole. I don't kill people in real life. Yet. Yo, yeah, it's a documentary. The Walking Dead is a documentary program. That shit really happened. So when you see Cutlass later on, that's just a ghost. People. I love Abraham! I'm teasing. Is your battery working, girl?
Is it?
Yeah, I hear you.
My daughter Catherine.
Hi Catherine.
Hi.
You're beautiful.
Hi Catherine. Yeah.
Hi Catherine.
How old are you?
13.
She's 13.
Hi, 13. What a great age. Happy teenagerness.
She loves your character, especially because of Lucille. Anytime she sees the bat, she just wants it. She loves it. October happens to be Down Syndrome Awareness Month, and okay. We've been giving everybody that we've been seeing, all the celebrities, bracelets, and we were wondering if we could give you a friendship bracelet.
Are you kidding me? Bring that on up here, Kat. Come here, girl. Come and say hi to all these fine people. Here, hold my hand. Everybody, this is Catherine. Stevens. She was a nurse in a show. And I super loved her. Except for you got a big scar on your forehead.
Yeah.
Thank you. I see the bracelet? Oh, I'll give you. Yeah, I can give it to Andy. Thank you very much. Negan's not such a bad guy. Catherine, thank you. You're awesome. And I'll get this to little Rick Grimes.